Hello everybody, today I'm going to show you how to turn a regular inventory into a custom inventory using just a single item. This will require less configuration on your behalf, since you only need to configure one item instead of two. So to start off this tutorial, I want to say that it isn't actually necessary to watch the full video. If you go to the actual web app, coolso.github.io/mccustomgui-gen, there is a direct link to an image guide here, so you can just follow these little steps here and you don't need to watch the whole video here. It's also nice because you can do it at your own pace instead of needing to pause the video occasionally. There are a few ways to customize your GUI. One is to take the texture from the Minecraft files directly, but another is to open up the inventory that you want to customize. When you have changed your video setting option GUI scale to 1, this makes it so each pixel here is exactly 1 pixel on the other result. So just take a screenshot of this, and then open it up in your favorite image editor. So with the screenshot open, I'm using GIMP here, you're going to want to select an area here that is 256 by 256. You can see that on the bottom there. And then copy this and open it up in a new area. Then you're going to want to customize this to see fit. I'm going to do that really quick here. Alright, so I finished making the little test inventory here, but I'd like to point out that if I was attempting to put this any lower, there is an area where the top will appear cut off. I've created this little image here just to show this here. You can see that all these areas here will render just fine, but anywhere lower and this top area will begin to be cut out. I will show an example of this. I do recommend that if you are putting the item not in the top corner but in a lower corner, to leave transparency here, which is similar to this, where it's simply just deleted out. I'm putting this item up in this corner, so I don't necessarily need to worry about that here. As you can see, this is what occurs when an item is rendering too low. This one is being put on my hotbar and rendering upwards. You can see that it cuts off some of the number of the chests that are in the chest above, and also you can see that the green doesn't render fully because it's cut off at the top. So in the finished inventory here, you're going to want to start by measuring from the top left corner here and dragging it to the top right corner of where the item would be positioned here. It's going to be positioned underneath this here. I still have the previous thing that I was working on here, which is now here, so I'm gonna take this note of these two coordinates, the size of the image, which I know to be 256 by 256, because that's how I started off this thing, and then I'm going to move over into the web tool here. So I'm gonna start by inputting the 256 for the width, and then the 256 for the height, and then I'm going to also input the size, that was 98 by 40, so 98 by 40, and then I'm going to input the image name, which I named custom GUI/test inventory. And then when I click on generate here, it's going to produce a whole bunch of text here, which will automatically all be selected when you click on it, so you can easily copy and paste it into a custom file, which I'm not going to show you in this video how to create custom items, but this is, if you know how to, I'm going to also link in the description of how to, then this will make your life modeling these custom GUIs so much easier. Alright, so I finished reloading the resource pack with the new textures and everything in it, so I'm going to give myself the diamond hoe that I need for this project, and then I'm going to put it right into the test inventory here. I'm going to grab these and stick that in there. So you can see here that this renders everything quite well. It does even allow for highlighting of the inventory squares, so you can easily put these items in here for whatever you might need. This is just an example here. However, if you are using this in more serious situations, you're going to want to make it so that people can't put items where they aren't supposed to go, as well as to not be able to pick up this little hoe here that is rendering this whole thing. But otherwise, that's all there really is to this video here. I'd like to thank you for watching, and have a pleasant day.